Children, now let's know about the other mode of reproduction in plants, which is vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? Vegetative propagation means if the plant reproduces through its body parts. The body parts are called vegetative parts. What are the body parts of a plant? The root, stem, and leaf are the body parts or vegetative parts of a plant, and some of the plants reproduce through these body parts. So when the plant reproduces through its vegetative parts, the reproduction is called vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. Okay. Now let's see how some root of the plant grow into new plants. Children, this is a carrot, and this carrot grows into new plant from this carrot itself. What is carrot? Carrot is the root of carrot plant. So when we bury this carrot in the soil, the stem will be growing from the topmost part of this carrot. Okay, so carrot can be a vegetative part of the plant, which is the root. Okay, another root is beetroot. You know, beetroot, this is also the root of the plant. When we bury this beetroot in the soil, it also grows stems and leaves. Okay, it can also be a new plant. So we can say beetroot also grow from root. And sweet potato, you know, sweet potato is also a root which also grows from its root. Okay, now let's know how the plant reproduces through stem. My dear children, this is the plant part of a rose, and the plant part of the of a plant which is used for producing a new plant is called stem cutting. So this is a stem cutting which later, if we plant in the soil, this will develop roots and grow into a new plant. And another stem, this is a potato. The potatoes are actually stems. They are not roots. They are underground stems. These also, when buried in the soil, they will be growing to new plants. And you know, children, this is ginger. Ginger is also a stem. This is also an underground stem from which new plants will be growing. And in some plants, leaves also grow into new plants. Okay, and in which plant did the leaf grow into a new plant? You know, in bryophyllum plant. Bryophyllum plant, the leaves grow into new plants. The leaves have buds in their notches. That means the ends of the leaves will be provided with small buds. When these buds grow in the soil, or when the leaves grow grown in the soil, fall in the soil, the buds seen at the ends of the leaves will be growing into new plants. Did you understand, children? So the plants not only reproduces through seeds, some of the plants will be reproduced through its vegetative parts. Okay, and some plants will be able to reproduce both through seeds and through its body parts. But some plants will only be able to reproduce through seeds. For example, mango tree. We cannot plant a branch of the mango tree into a new plant. We can grow it from its seed. Just like that, the coconut and many trees will be growing out of seeds. But in the case of this rose, we will not be able to grow a rose plant from its seed. we normally cut a branch, and it is called stem cutting, with which we can make new plants. And some parts of the plant, such as roots and stems, will be able to grow into new plants. And in bryophyllum plant, the leaf which has buds, which grows into a new plant. So this is known as vegetative propagation.